One of the main characters from this time period was Rhaenys Targaryen, Rhaenyra's right hand. Princess Rhaenys Targaryen, known among the small folk as the Queen Who Never was the daughter of Prince Aemon Targaryen and Lady Jocelyn Baratheon, born in 74 AC, on the 7th day of the 7th month. Rhaenys Targaryen was the granddaughter of Jaehaerys I Targaryen, and the cousin of Viserys I Targaryen and Aemon Targaryen. Rhaenys was a great beauty. She was a clever, capable, spirited, proud, fierce, and fearless woman. She had a fiery temperament. Rhaenys wore steel and copper armor, which flashed on the sun, as her father was the Prince of Dragonstone, and she was his firstborn child. Many considered her as being next in line for the Iron Throne, after her father Aemon. Queen Alysanne Targaryen, when being presented with her granddaughter, called her our queen-to-be. Rhaenys became a dragon rider in 87 AC, when she claimed the dragon Meleys, the Red Queen. Rhaenys married legendary Corlys of House Velaryon, known as the Sea Snake, in 90 AC at the age of 16. Rhaenys' father, Prince Aemon Targaryen, died in 92 AC. As Aemon had been the Prince of Dragonstone, King Jaehaerys I Targaryen had to formally appoint a new heir to the Iron Throne. The choice was between Rhaenys, Aemon's only child and heir, and Aemon's brother, Baelon. Jaehaerys appointed Baelon as the new Prince of Dragonstone, passing over pregnant Rhaenys and her unborn child. Rhaenys herself was the first to object to the king's decision, and her husband, Lord Corlys Velaryon, gave up his position as Lord Admiral and his place on the Small Council. Following that, Rhaenys and her husband returned to Driftmark. Others angered by the king's decision included Rhaenys' mother, Lady Jocelyn Baratheon, her uncle, Lord Bormund Baratheon, and her grandmother, King Jaehaerys' wife, Queen Alysanne Targaryen. Rhaenys gave birth to her first child, a daughter she named Lena Velaryon, late in the year 92 AC. The following year, she gave birth to a son, Laenor Velaryon. Although both House Velaryon and House Baratheon insisted that Laenor had the better claim to the throne, Prince Baelon remained King Jaehaerys' heir. When Baelon died in 101 AC, King Jaehaerys called the first great council at Harrenhal to decide the matter of succession. 14 claims were considered, including the claims of Rhaenys and her children. Rhaenys' uncle, Lord Bormund Baratheon, was outspoken in supporting the claims of Rhaenys and her son Laenor during the Great Council, and Lord Ellard Stark gave his support to Rhaenys and Corlys as well. Other supporters included House Dustin of Barrington and House Manderly of White Harbor. Yet the claims of Rhaenys and her daughter were rejected, on account that they are females. Rhaenys and Corlys used their wealth and influence to persuade the lords present to vote for their son Laenor, one of the two primary claimants. For this, they received support from Lord Bormund, Lord Ellard, Lord Manderly, Lord Dustin, Lord Blackwood, Lord Bar Emmon, Lord Celtigare, as well as others. However, Laenor was eventually passed over in favor of Baelon's son Viserys. While the vote was kept secret, it was rumored the assembled lords favored Viserys by 20-1, for having been passed over in the line of succession once again. The court jester Mushroom would name her the Queen Who Never Was. Following the death of Queen Emma Arryn in 105 AC, Grand Maester Runcider suggested to King Viserys I Targaryen that he shall take Rhaenys' 12-year-old daughter Lena to wife. King Viserys, however, chose Alysanne Hightower. Angered by the third time she and her family had been scorned by House Targaryen, Rhaenys and her family did not attend the royal wedding in 106 AC. In 113 AC, King Viserys I and his small council began discussions concerning a betrothal for Princess Rhaenyra Targaryen, Viserys' heir. They eventually agreed on Rhaenys' son Laenor. Rhaenyra and Laenor were wed the next year. Rhaenys' daughter Lena was married to Daemon Targaryen, the Rogue Prince. Both of Rhaenys' children died in 120 AC. Lena died in childbirth, during the early days of the year, while Laenor was killed by Sir Quarrel Corey while attending a fair in Spicetown. When the Dance of the Dragons began in 129 AC, Princess Rhaenys sat on the Black Council of Queen Rhaenyra Targaryen, the daughter of the late King Viserys I Targaryen. When the Velaryon fleet closed off the Gullet, sailing forth from Dragonstone and Driftmark to block all shipping for Blackwater Bay, the Black's plan was for Rhaenys to fly overhead on Meleys, to keep the Greens from attacking their ships with dragons. When news arrived on Dragonstone about the death of Lucerys Velaryon at the hands of Prince Aemond Targaryen, Rhaenys and her husband prevented Lucerys' brother Joffrey from mounting his dragon to avenge his brother. Grief-stricken following the death of Lucerys, Queen Rhaenyra Targaryen gave Rhaenys and Corlys command over her war council. When Rook's Rest was attacked by Sir Criston Cole and the Greens, as Aegon II's supporters were called, Rhaenyra sent her aunt to burn the army and save the fort. Mounted on her dragon Meleys, Rhaenys unexpectedly turned up at Rook's Nest and laid waste to the enemy army. However, Rhaenys was flying into a trap. Her nephew Aemond Targaryen confronted her on his monstrous dragon Vagar, the last of the original three Targaryen dragons that conquered Westeros, along with the king himself on his magnificent dragon Sunfire. Despite being outnumbered, Rhaenys did not flee. Rhaenys turned to meet the attack, despite the knowledge that Meleys stood no chance against the two dragons. Meleys' flame faced Vagar's and Sunfire's, until it looked like that there was a second sun in the sky. The three dragons attacked each other and fell to the ground, entangled. By the time the fight was over, Aemond and Vagar were the only ones uninjured, while Aegon had to have a constant dose of milk of the poppy to survive, and Sunfire, who laid on top of Aegon, was wounded, and the wing almost completely torn off. It was crippled and would never fly again. Meleys had been torn to shreds, and Rhaenys was just ash and bone. That was Rhaenys' brave last stand, where she died for Rhaenyra's cause. Rhaenys' husband Corlys the Sea Snake was enraged that Rhaenyra had sent his wife Rhaenys to the battle alone, rather than going herself or ordering her sons to accompany Rhaenys. Beloved daughter of Lady Jocelyn Baratheon and Prince Aemon Targaryen, faithful wife of Lord Corlys Velaryon, mother and grandmother, the queen who never was lived fearlessly and died amidst blood and fire. She was 55 years old, is how Gildane describes her in Fire and Blood. Rhaenys Targaryen will definitely be one of my favorite characters in the House of the Dragon. Fierce and smart woman, brave and loyal. Honorable woman who upholds her oath to Queen Rhaenyra and who fought for her cause, so fiercely that not even Vagar and Sunfire combined could fear her away. Legendary characters such as Rhaenys Targaryen. Legendary battles such as the Siege of the Rook's Rest, in which Rhaenys flew her dragon, the Red Queen, straight into Aegon and Aemond, despite being outnumbered by their two dragons, out of which one was mighty Vagar. Rhaenys could have fled, but she chose to fight and went down in epic battle in Fire and Blood. All of that and more this Game of Thrones prequel show House of the Dragon brings in 2022. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a big thumbs up, and I hope to see you in the next one. Peace!